Chapter 9. My Personal Branding Story. My personal brand story in Singapore is one of ups and downs, but with a happy ending. Well, happy middle, seeing as I'm only just getting started. Yes, I already shared this story in the first chapter. However, we'll revisit it here to look at it specifically from a personal branding angle, so that you can enhance your own personal branding based on my good and not-so-good moves. As given in Chapter 1, I was an entrepreneur in the UK, and after I exited my three marketing businesses over there, I came to Singapore to become an entrepreneur. Before I discovered the power of LinkedIn and launched my company, Black Marketing, I worked for another string of companies, learning about the culture and building my personal brand. I was reminded of this when I recently appeared on the front page of the Business Times here in Singapore. The last time I was on the front page of a newspaper in Singapore was some years earlier, and it was due to a blog I wrote about Singaporean taxi drivers. That blog post led me to be fired from my role at the time, and it was one of the most stressful times in my life. At that time, not only was I featured in the tabloid rag, the new paper, but I was also featured in every other newspaper in Singapore, as well as many Chinese, Malaysian, Tamilian and English papers. I was also featured on Channel News Asia and Asia One websites, not to mention a million other online chat rooms and discussion forums. This is where I really got to know the underbelly of Singapore. I still find it amazing that people on LinkedIn don't comprehend that what they post on LinkedIn represents their company as well as themselves, something that my taxi driver blog post drove home to me big time. On LinkedIn, everyone can see who you work for, so technically, everything you post is being either positively or negatively associated with and endorsed by the company you work for. That's why I always recommend thinking twice before posting on LinkedIn, particularly if you're the boss like I am. On the bright side, the controversy from my blog post actually didn't stop me from getting taxis, despite the fact that the new paper created a graphic that said in Chinese, "Beware of this man." Controversy's glass half full. That experience gave me brand recognition and even elicited sympathy from people, some of whom said that I was harshly treated by my former employer, by anonymous trolls online and the media, even if they disagreed with what I did and said. It became a talking point. I was able to use it as a way to move from a negative position to a positive one at a business meeting, and it opened up a dialogue to discuss what I could do for that person in a professional capacity. They would then look beyond that controversy to consider what I could actually do for them. Controversy is often essential to a personal brand, especially one like mine. I run a small SME and am trying to stand out against multinationals and other social media agencies who are trying to specialize in LinkedIn and sell themselves as supposed LinkedIn trainers, many of whom don't even use the platform themselves. I have been banned by the Entrepreneur Organisation, the British Chamber of Commerce, the Australian Chamber of Commerce, Primetime Professional Women's Association and more for being too controversial, whatever that means. Guess they just didn't want to be associated with a punk with a mohawk. That and the fact I used each organisation, which after all are voluntary, to market my firm, and why not? Isn't that what business associations are supposed to be for? Apparently not. They're just talking shops for multinationals and people who are going nowhere and wish to tick a box saying that they are doing something for CSR when they're not. They're not actually helping entrepreneurs grow their businesses. I am from Newcastle upon Tyne, in the true north of England, and where I come from, people are very direct. They speak their minds and tell you the truth directly and without care of the consequence. Better to be true to yourself than fake, Geordies say. FYI, people from Newcastle are called Geordies. Marketing was a hard job in Newcastle. That was why I moved 500 kilometres south to London, where they tend to believe things more readily and where marketing works more easily. My blogs follow this adage, as does my sale pitch. As my many clients can testify, I will tell you how terrible your LinkedIn profile, personal brand, social selling and content marketing are before demonstrating what you should be doing and how you can use the platform to win clients and enhance your personal brand. Fellow entrepreneurs appreciate my honesty. I'm not smooth-talking them. Instead, I'm giving it to them straight. Not everyone appreciates my style, but everyone at least knows I'm speaking from the heart. Even if they don't use us to enhance their LinkedIn marketing, they can see what they're missing out on and they go and do it for themselves. Of course, the infamy I attained after that blog post made me look at things differently. I wouldn't recommend the experience to anyone, but it hardens you up and makes you more aware of your actions and responsibilities as a guest in someone else's country. To this day, my experience is something that people still discuss, and of course, there are still traces of it on Google. Fortunately, all my more noteworthy achievements in business since then take priority in my Google search results. But type Chris Reed, Taxi, Singapore, and you can still find 100 forums of hate from the time. I was described by Mumbrella magazine, a niche marketing publication online, as opinion splitting, controversial, and colourful, as they sold their adverts by using my name in their headlines to drive views. Easy prey. I happily obliged them, rode the wave, and answered every single comment, anonymous, trolls, abusive, and the rest. Water off a duck's back at this stage. I appeared a few times on Channel News Asia, but they recently banned me as I was too incendiary to have on the show. They made reference to one of my many infamous and famous rock t-shirts that I wear, which said, "Enjoy cocaine" and "Fuck apples," with a photo of Snow White enjoying some lines. I live in Singapore and wore it to a trance event. I was clearly being ironic, but they didn't get that. Sometimes it's just too easy to shock and surprise people. For a time, the only NASDAQ CEO with a mohawk. In 2015, after I sold part of my fourth business, Black Marketing, only the Singapore part, I was briefly the only NASDAQ CEO with a mohawk. People queried that even calling myself that was controversial. But I was a CEO of a NASDAQ-listed company, so calling myself the only NASDAQ CEO with a mohawk was an accurate description. That didn't last long for many reasons. I'll tell you over a beer. I resigned. I wasn't fired and launched my fifth business, All Black Ventures, which owns my brands globally like Black Marketing, Chris J. Reed Mastery, my Masterclass brand, and every other brand that I create and launch. In launching All Black Ventures, I became truly independent again. But in the process, it generated more controversy. Ask anyone about me and they'll have an opinion about me and not all will be good. I have the classic Marmite brand. Love me or hate me, but you can't ignore me. As Oscar Wilde said, there is only one thing in the world worse than being talked about, and that is not being talked about. The surprise is that the adage, all publicity is good publicity, is actually true in this context, although I didn't think so at the time I was fired from my job. It gave me name recognition beyond my circle and beyond LinkedIn. To this day, people still refer to me as infamous as a result. Since then, I have built my personal brand and learnt from my experience. I am still forthright because I believe that all blogs and posts should be that way, but I think that society is now more accepting of more provocative content, and there are more blogs out there with far more outrageous things in them. There's a reason that I have 2,000 LinkedIn recommendations. My LinkedIn masterclass is the best in the world. My firm, Black Marketing, delivers the best LinkedIn marketing service in the world when we take over your LinkedIn profile and manage it for you. We genuinely make our clients all over the world into LinkedIn rock stars. The infamous blog post experience directly led me to create Black Marketing, enabling LinkedIn for you. This happened both because of my terrible employment choices after I was fired, but also because the experience gave me a greater understanding of the Singaporean culture, people, and region. With name recognition, along with the enhanced personal branding that my notoriety gave me, I was in a strong position to launch Black Marketing with confirmed clients. It was a running start. Since then, we have gone from strength to strength, won awards such as Social Media Agency of the Year, B2B Marketing Agency of the Year, B2B Influencer of the Year, and B2B Social Media Influencer of the Year, as well as producing 4 number one international best-selling books about LinkedIn. Yes, this very book is among them. All of these milestones led to the Business Times featuring me on their front cover. They wrote about how I am the only marketing entrepreneur who made LinkedIn central to their business model. Not only am I servicing entrepreneurs for their LinkedIn marketing strategies, but I am actually using LinkedIn myself to enhance my personal brand, company brand, and content marketing, and for lead generation. I am effectively proving it works, practicing what I preach. I mentor marketing and non-marketing graduates from many business schools and universities. I regularly speak at Singaporean organisations like NTUC to graduates and young Singaporeans, and I also speak at education establishments to spread the word about LinkedIn. I speak at many non-profit organisations for no fee to inspire them to use LinkedIn to enhance their personal brand and enhance their professional credentials. I also meet anyone who wants advice about their LinkedIn profile and regularly give people tips on LinkedIn with no hope of getting money for it. Good business karma. I give back to the country and its people where I have created a successful LinkedIn marketing business, and I now very much call Singapore my home. As of 2019, I renounced my UK passport and became a Singaporean citizen, which was one of the proudest moments of my life, because it's so hard to become Singaporean. Most people get rejected. I, of course, posted about this on LinkedIn and got a million views, probably mostly from people thinking, how did he manage to become a Singaporean? Over a decade after I arrived in Singapore, I am looking forward to taking Black Marketing into a decade of service for entrepreneurs all over the world. The next chapter continues our exploration of personal branding by its look at my mohawk. We look at my mohawk to get you pumped about your metaphorical mohawk.